disease we caught it early, and with aggressive treatment, this kind of cancer is... There's every reason to be optimistic. I'm going to put you in touch with the best oncologist here at the hospital. He's really one of the best in the country.
Familiar. Have we met before?
I'm really gonna be late for work.
I'm sorry, I just thought... Is something wrong?
It's just one of those days, you know.
Really? The day just started.
Do you want to grab a cup of coffee?
So... I'm kind of like your muse?
I draw a lot of people I see on the train.
Oh, and I thought I was something special. It's nice. You're a great artist.
Thank you.
So why did you sketch me?
No reason.
No, seriously, why me?
Well, that night that I saw you on the train, you looked like you had just lost something. You looked like you had just lost something and you realized that you were never gonna find it. It was really beautiful.
I wasn't expecting it to be this nice out.
I don't remember the last time I had a day off like this.
Really?
I never skip work. So you really think that there's more after all this?
After we die?
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely think so.
Oh. Are you some sort of religious freak or something?
I'm not saying there's a heaven or a hell, or some big man ruling over us in the sky. I think that we're made up energy, and that energy continues on after we die. I guess you don't.
Well, no, I don't. I think that this is it. I think that life begins and ends right here. I think that a lot of people want to believe in some great big beyond, but I think that's mostly because they're scared to live their life to the fullest, right here, right now. I think it's a lot easier for most people to think that in the next life, that's when they'll be happy. That's when they're going to really be what they truly are, you know?
No, it's not.
It's not what?
Easier. Believing in something greater and bigger than yourself, it helps you to grow and evolve as a human being.
Yeah, well, I would hope that you could do that without the threat of an afterlife.
Nope. Without it, I would probably be a very vile and disgusting human being.
Oh, how? Mm. Well, he sounds a little more interesting than you are.
But...
What?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Huh.
Wow.
You got some cold one here.
Yeah.
Like, just packed into ice and just,
Yeah, what can I say? What can I say?
All right, well, I mean, I guess that's fair.
When you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. I just wanna see. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it.
Hey, where do you see yourself in 10 years?
What is this, a job interview?
No, I'm just thinking. I can't really see myself being here
for much longer.
I think it'd be nice to settle someplace a little more still.
Stillness is nice.
Two-story house, a garden.
Yeah, stars in the sky, exactly. Crickets at night.
Exactly. What about you?
I don't know.
Come on. Just close your eyes.
No.
Now, imagine yourself the most interesting place you can be. What do you see?
Darkness.
Really?
Yeah, seriously, that's what I see.
You can be any place in the world.
Maybe I would be at the ocean, the beach, the warm sun. Maybe I would have a kid, and they could play with a dog, and I would just sketch them.
Okay. I think I'm going to change my answer.